Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life Science with KMD. Today I am going to explain about mode of pollination. First we should know what is the difference between cross-pollination and a self-pollination. Cross-pollination is a transfer of pollen grain from the anther of a flower to the stigma of the flower of a different plant of the same species. Whereas self-pollination is a transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma of the same flower. So this occur in the same flower, but here it occur in the different flower from a different plant of the same species. So that is the difference between self-pollination and a cross-pollination species. In case of cross-pollination, a pollinator will be involved in this process. Either it could be like wind, or either it could be insect, animal, or water, or it could be through wind also. So it is seen in case of, if the pollinator, if it is an insect, then the plants which are comes under cross pollination are apple, grapes, plum, pears, raspberry, blackberries, strawberries, runner beans, pumpkins, daffodils, tulips, lavender. If the pollinator is a wind, then example are grasses, catkins, dandelion, maple trees, and goat's beard. Self-pollinated crops, example for self-pollinated crops are some of the legumes. Example is peanut, orchid, peas, and sunflower, wheat, barley, oats, rice, tomatoes, potatoes, apricot, and peaches. These are all self-pollinated crops. Now, transfer with the help of, as I told, in case of cross-pollination, it could be transferred through wind, insect, water, or animals. Whereas in case of self-pollinated crops, it will be like shed pollen directly onto the stigma. Next, plant differences is that what is the morphological difference between the cross-pollinated and the self-pollinated plants? A slight variation will be there, not much. It's like brightly colored petals will be seen so that it can attract the insect or the animals. So it is brightly colored petals, nectars will be produced, and it is scented. The flowers will be more scented. Long stamens and pistils are seen in case of cross-pollinated crops. Whereas in case of self-pollinated crops, the flowers are very small. This is the difference between cross-pollinated plants and self-pollinated plants. So what are the result of this cross-pollination and self-pollination in crops? In case of cross-pollination, more varieties of the species can be seen. Whereas in case of self-pollinated crops, it is more uniform progenies are seen. So this cross-pollination allow for diversity in the species as genetic information of different plants are combined. However, it rely on the existence of the pollinator that will travel from plant to plant. Whereas in case of self-pollinated crops, allow the plant to be less resistant as a whole to disease. However, it does not need to expend energy. It doesn't has to spend his energy on attracting the pollinator, and can spread beyond the area where suitable pollinator can be found. So even the difference is, one more difference is the number of pollen grains. In case of cross-pollinated crops, number of pollen grains will be more. Whereas in case of self-pollinated crops, the number of pollen grain is very less or in small quantity. Type of reproduction, mainly in case of cross-pollination, is allogamy. Whereas in case of self-pollinated crops, it could be autogamy or genitogamy. So this I'm going to explain in the next slides. and it occurs in either perfect or imperfect flower. So in cross-pollinated crops, it occur in a perfect or an imperfect flower, whereas in case of self-pollination is seen in case of perfect flowers. So if we come to the pollination, classification of the pollination, it could be two types, as I already told, that is self-pollinated crops or cross-pollinated crops, which is also called as xenogamy. So self-pollinated crops are further divided into autogamy, that means same flowers are involved, and second one is the genitogamy, where different flowers of the same plants are involved. Whereas in case of cross-pollinated, cross-pollination is further divided into either it involves a abiotic agency or a biotic agency. Abiotic agency, like if it is involving wind, then it is called as anemophily, whereas if it is a water, then it is called as hydrophily. In case of biotic agencies, like if it is involving a insect, then it is called as entomophily. Bat means cheiropterophily. Snail means malacophily. Birds means ornithophily. So this is how both self-pollinated and cross-pollinated crops are classified. Self-pollination. It is a transfer of pollen grain from the anther to the flower to the stigma of either the same or genetically similar flower. Accordingly, self-pollination is of two types, autogamy or gynogamy. Autogamy, it is a type of self-pollination in which the intersexual or perfect flower is pollinated by its own pollen. Autogamy occur by two methods. One is homogamy, the anther and the stigma of the chasmogamous or open flower are brought together by growth, binding or folding. Cleistogamy, in cleistogamous flower, the anther dehiscence inside the closed flower. Growth of style bring the pollen grain in contact with the stigma. Pollination and seed set are assured. Pollinators are not required. Gynetogamy, it is a type of pollination in which the pollen grain of one flower, it transfers to the stigma of another flower belonging to either same plant or genetically similar plant. In gynetogamy, the flower often show modification similar to ones found in the xenogamy or cross-pollination. Advantages and disadvantages of self-pollinated and in self-pollinated crops. The advantages of self-pollination is that it maintains the parental characteristics or purity of the race indefinitely. So the disadvantage in this is that new useful characters are seldom introduced. Then self-pollination is used to maintain pure line for hybridization experiment. Disadvantage is that vigor and vitality of the race decrease with prolonged self-pollination. Plant does not need to produce large number of pollen grains. Whereas disadvantage of self-pollination is immunity to disease decreases. Then flower do not develop device for attracting insect pollinator. Adaptability to change environment are reduced. Cross pollination or xenogamy or allogamy. Cross pollination is the transfer of pollen grain from the anther of one flower to the stigma of another genetically different flower. Cross-pollination is performed with the help of external agency. Anemophily, it is a mode of cross-pollination or transfer of pollen grain through agency of wind. Example is coconut palm, date palm, maize, many grasses and cannabis. Characteristics of anemophily, the flower are colorless, odorless and nectarless. polar grain are pollen grains are light, smell, very light, small, winged or dusty, dry, smooth, non-sticky and unwettable. Stigma is hairy, feathery or branched to catch the wind-borne pollen grain. Pollen grain are produced in very large number. Next is hydrophily. It is a mode of pollination or transfer of pollen grain through the agency of water. Example is Zostera vallisneria. Characteristics are the flower are small and inconspicuous. Nectar and odor are absent. Pollen grain are light and unwettable due to the presence of mucilage cover. Stigma is long, sticky but unwettable. Entomophily. The pollen grains are transferred through the agency of insect like moth, butterfly, wasp, bee, beetle, etc. Now the characteristics are showy or brightly colored. Most insect pollinated flowers have a landing platform. Pollen grains are spiny, heavy, surrounded by a yellow oil sticky substance called pollen kit. Stigmas are often inserted and sticky. Some flower provide safe place to insect and lay egg. Example is yucca. Ornithophily. It is a mode of allogamy performed by birds. Only a few types of birds are specialized for this. They usually have a small size and long beak. Characters are ornithophilous flowers are usually brightly colored, red or orange or yellow or blue color. Flower parts are commonly leathery. Ornithophilous flowers secrete abundant watery nectar or have edible part. Scent are often absent. Methods to ensure cross-pollination. Dichogamy. Anther and stigma mature at different time in bisexual flower so as to prevent self-pollination. Protoandry. The anther mature earlier than stigma of the same flower. Their pollen grain become available to stigma of the older flower. Example is sunflower, salvia. Protogyny. Stigma mature earlier so that they get pollinated before the anther of the same flower develop pollen grain. Example is Mirabilis jalapa, that is 4 o'clock plant, and Gloriosa plantago. Hercogamy. Some bisexual flower, the structure of the male and female sex organs itself provide a barrier for self-pollination. Next is self-sterility or self-incompatibility. Pollen grains of the flower do not germinate on the stigma of the same flower due to the presence of similar self-sterile genes, that is S1, S3 in pistil and S1 and S3 in pollen grains. Example is tobacco, potato and crucifers. Next is heterostyle. There are two or three types of flowers with different height of styles and stamens. Diheterostyle or dimorphic heterostyle. There are two types of flower, pinheaded long style and short stamen. Torum-eyed, short style and long stamen. Example is Primula, that is primrose. Triheterostyle or trimorphic heterostyle or tristyle. These are three types of flowers with different height of style. Example is Lythrum. Pollination occur between anther and the stigma. of the same height presents in different flower. Importance of cross-pollination. Advantages and disadvantages. Cross-pollination introduce genetic recombination and hence variation in progeny. Disadvantage is the factor of chance is always involved in cross-pollination. Cross-pollination increase the adaptability of the offspring towards change in environment. It makes the organism better fitted in the struggle for existence. Plant produced through cross-pollination is more resistant to diseases. Disadvantages: it is less economical. Some undesirable characters may creep in the race. The very good character of the race are likely to be spoiled. Coevolution of flower and its pollinator species. Coevolution is evolution in two species that interact extensively with one another so that each act as a major force of natural selection on the other. When one evolve a new feature or modify itself, the other evolve new adaptation in response to it. This constant mutual feedback modification between the two species is known as coevolution. The coevolution of the flower and its pollinator species are tightly linked with one another. Dicea naivea is a rare orchid found in only few places in South Africa, and until Johansson came to study it, no one knew how it was pollinated. After a lot of patience orchid watching, he and his colleague discovered that it is visited exclusively by a fly shown in the picture. So its proboscis is well matched to the length of the orchid, and the orchid grow pollen in just the right place so that they get stuck to the fly. You can see them in this picture. The two dangle yellow pocket on the fly's snout. This fly is named as orchid fly. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.